So it's very exciting. This film is a sequel to a very popular first film. Very popular books.
Yeah.
But it's an erotic subject matter, Dakota.
It is?
It is. It's very titillating, this film. And the film that preceded it. But you have
titillating.
Titillating. I know it's a terrible word, but it is. I did use it correctly.
You did.
But you have, is it weird because these films are a very adult subject matter. Is it strange when, like, younger fans come up to you and say they're fans?
Well, yeah. Yes. I mean, I'm often like, really?
Yeah.
But I recently was in a Starbucks getting some coffee.
Yeah. getting some easy listening CDs.
Yeah, as you do. Just, you know. And a kid came up to me, he was probably like 14 or 15. He was like, hey, can I get a picture with you? I was like, yeah, of course. And he's like holding his phone out like this. And he's like, I actually don't know who you are, but my mom is over there and she's like freaking out. And I look over and this woman is just like face down on a table. Can't make eye contact with me.
The only way to bring my mother back to life is a photo of you.
Yeah, send your son into the fire.
Yeah, also, it is that great thing when people feel like they need to tell you, because I've had that happen before. Where people also, they want a picture, but they also want to let you know they don't know who you are.
Yeah, they're like, I actually don't care, but like, can I get a picture with you?
Yeah, someone else got a picture, and now I want one, but I'll probably never look at it.
Yeah.
And as soon as this is over, I'm gonna delete it for the storage space.
Yeah.
But I did want to take up your time and make you feel bad.
Yeah, and then I go home and cry.
Yeah, it like ruins the week.
Yeah.
So this, because this film has such a, you know, from these very popular books, it seems like when you do press, I have found, anything you say...
It's a disaster.
Well, it's not a disaster, but anything you say, like, people... You can give people very clickbaity headlines, I feel like, based on any answer you give. It's not your fault.
No, it is truly categorically impossible for me to get it right.
To talk about this film in a way where it's just a boring thing.
When I'm not, like, wildly taken out of context.
What's it... Like, how... What's an example of how you get taken out of context?
Well, I mean, the other day I had a... someone asked me what my favorite sex toy was.
Yeah.
Which is, like, inappropriate.
Yeah.
And I was like, that's an inappropriate question. Also, if I answer it, I can't answer it the right way. I also can't answer, if I say, like, I said I don't have one.
Yeah.
Let's move on. But then the headline was like, she doesn't have one favorite sex toy. So it's like I can't win. It's like I hate sex toys, so why am I doing this movie? Or I love them and I'm a sex
You
fiend?
Should just give an answer. Just say one that doesn't exist. Just be like, the scrambler.
Yeah.
And then if they say they don't know what the scrambler is, be like, oh, you should find out.
Yeah.
It's going to change your life.
Yeah.
It seems masks. I've seen masks in the poster for this film. Like sexy masks.
Yeah, not like gimp masks.
No. But this is like...
Not no.
Like, oh, what?
Not no.
No, not no. But like the masks are... Do you find the masks alluring? Is that something...
Alluring?
Yeah, like to wear... like.
If I answer this question, I'd be like, she loves masks.
you already blew it with the gimp mask actor.
I know.
The headline's gonna be, Dakota Johnson has a favorite mask. You won't believe what it is.
I know, but truly, it's like, if I were playing a dental hygienist, would the questions be like,
Do you floss?
Do you love people's mouths?
Is it weird now? Like, when you floss, do you always think about the movie?